here at United Nations, I join you in welcoming the new year. We enter 2020 with uncertainty and insecurity all around. Persistent inequality and rising hatred, a warring world and a warming planet. Climate change is not only a long-term problem, but a clear and present danger. And we cannot afford to be the generation that fiddled while the planet burned. But there is also hope. This year, my New Year's message is to the greatest source of that hope, the world's young people. From climate action to gender equality to social justice and human rights, your generation is on the front lines and in the headlines. I'm inspired by your passion and determination. You are rightly demanding a role in shaping the future, and I am with you. The United Nations stands with you and belongs to you. 2020 marks the 75th anniversary of the United Nations. We are launching a decade of action for the Sustainable Development Goals, our blueprint for a fair globalization. This year, the world needs young people to keep speaking out, keep thinking big, keep pushing boundaries, and keep up the pressure. I wish you peace and happiness in 2020. Thank you. I'm issuing a global call for a decade of action to deliver the Sustainable Development Goals by 2030. We have the best solution in the Agenda 2030, our blueprint for a fair globalization. We must step up our efforts, and we must do it now.
Crisis has impacted literally on every aspect of life, the economy and society, and we're going to have to methodically and systematically and carefully work our way through how we fix the impact, where it's done damage, and where we change how we do things in the future. So I don't have all of the answers to that right now, and I think Parliament would rightly be a bit miffed if I stood up here and tried to give you all of the answers to that right now. But just as we did at the outset of this crisis to put in place the protection against eviction, as we move into a different phase, we will have to consider what protections are appropriate for a longer term period and what bigger changes we want to see. Actually, everybody in this chamber has a part to play in that, as have the entirety of the Scottish population. I would never, ever, ever have wished the circumstances in which we're having these discussions, but it is undoubtedly the case that it gives us an opportunity to change things for the better.
And keep up the pressure.
It's important in the short term, but it is also vital to help lay the groundwork for a sustainable economic recovery.
Together we're tackling COVID-19, but now it's time to work together on recovery. For our part, the SNP will work tirelessly to protect jobs, to support businesses, and to invest in the industries of the future. We've already started by investing £230 million in a return to work package to invest in jobs across the country, as well as supporting industries that have been hard hit, like the oil and gas, to transition to green energy. We can all help Scotland recover from the impacts of COVID-19. So let's get on with building a more resilient, sustainable country that's fairer for everyone.
And I want to again today give an assurance that the Scottish Government is determined to do everything we can to support that process of rebuilding and recovery. We will continue to do everything possible to protect your livelihoods. That's important in the short term, but it is also vital to help lay the groundwork for a sustainable economic recovery.
In the longer term, or where we go, there is no question that poverty is the biggest single driver of ill health. And while Scotland has the lowest average poverty levels of the four nations, what you see right across the UK over the last decade, particularly since 2012, is rising child poverty. And that's because of welfare cuts. The two-child limit, the benefit cap, the benefit freeze, all of these things have hit families. Now, where I do agree with Michelle is that you need a joined-up health and well-being in all policies. You have to look across everything. But the Scottish Government has been trying to do that. They were the founder of the Wellbeing Economy Global Governments Group with New Zealand and Iceland. But I think we've had our economy and our society brought to an absolute standstill with COVID. And I don't think we should be building back to business as usual. I think we need to be building forward. We should be looking at the economy we need to have in 10 years. And that needs to be fairer, it needs to be greener, and it needs to be aimed at the physical, mental and environmental well-being of all of our citizens.
Well, tell us what that would be.
I think what we need to do is look at a universal basic income.
That's an idea it's never been so much discussed as it has during this pandemic. I mean, one thing we want to do is make sure that our new normal is better than the normal that has seen families impoverished, people living very precariously in hand-to-mouth jobs.
I'm issuing a global call for a decade of action to deliver the Sustainable Development Goals by 2030. We have the best solution in the Agenda 2030, our blueprint for a fair globalization. We must step up our efforts, and we must do it